Traditionally, interfaces contain only constants and abstract methods, but starting with Java 8, we now have default methods and static methods also in interfaces. An interface is described to be a class-like construct, and whereas abstract classes contain abstract methods and so do interfaces, they do have that in common. But the purpose of an interface is to capture common behavior for objects. Often we would describe this as common properties. So for example, all the different objects that can be compared could be classed as having the comparable interface. Objects that can be cloned can be classed as having the clonable interface. And the author of your textbook makes up a toy example, edible, and captures that particular property by using an interface. Objects which have such particular properties are said to implement the interface. Next, we'll discuss how to define an interface. Since an interface is not a class, we do have a separate way of declaring interfaces. You would say public interface and then give the name of the interface, and then you would define in a block any of the constant declarations and the signatures of the abstract methods that go with the interface. So for example, the author's toy example of editable is captured here by saying public interface editable, and then there is an abstract method called how to eat. There is no implementation for it, but it's just a placeholder, and once again you'll notice that after the method signature we immediately have a semicolon. There's no implementation, not even a set of empty curly braces are there, but absolutely nothing, because the implementation is left for other classes that actually use this interface or implement the interface, as we say. Although an interface is not the same as a class, it's treated like a special class in Java in the sense that whereas all classes get compiled into a separate bytecode file, interfaces would also be compiled into a bytecode file as well. Just as it's not possible to create an instance from an abstract class, you also are not able to create instances of interfaces using the new operator. The use of an interface is similar to how you would use an abstract class, but in terms of declarations and so on, we're going to see some differences, because again, we would never say that a class inherits from an interface, but rather we would use different language. We would say a class implements the interface. And this language makes sense because since the interface contains only abstract methods, it's going to be up to other classes to implement those methods, and that's why we say a class implements an interface. Now, just as we can still use abstract classes to represent data types and the results of casting and so on, the same is also true for interfaces.